What's really happening at Sheikh Jarrah? In 1875, a Jewish rabbi purchased this empty property in Sheikh Jarrah and has maintained ownership of it ever since. When the Jordanians illegally occupied Jerusalem in 1948 and ethnically cleansed it of Jews, including destroying synagogues, they built 28 homes for Palestinians who currently live there today. In 1967, the property was annexed to Israel after the Six-Day War. All this while Jews still owned this property. Years later, a Jewish organization purchased the property and appealed to the Israeli courts, who requested both sides, the Palestinians and the Israelis, come to an agreement in which the Palestinians would pay rent as tenants. They tried to fight the case in court, but lost, and are now facing eviction after not paying rent for years. Here's what you need to know. This is an ongoing and complicated legal case, and both sides have a legitimate claim. But the Palestinians could remain in their homes if they agreed to pay rent. They refused. Why? Propaganda. They are using this case to make a production to incite violence against Israel, even though the facts of the case prove something else entirely. If the same situation occurred anywhere else, the reactions wouldn't be the same. Tenants who don't pay rent get evicted, and nobody uses it as an excuse to launch terror attacks. The US members of Congress who are condemning Israel over this issue are fanning the flames of antisemitism at a time when we have a rise in antisemitism in the United States and we're dealing with violence against Jews in Israel. To the elected officials commenting, "You're being duped. Attacking Israel over Sheikh Jarrah isn't fighting for justice, it's irresponsibility. As an American Israeli, I'm begging you, stop fueling antisemitism."